updated. The following is the following is the trial balance of Mr. Ramesh. For the year ended 31st March 2014. Particulars: debit, credit. You know the format of a trial balance: particulars column, debit column, credit column. Write down. Opening stock. Opening stock. Please tell me which balance should opening stock show? It should show a debit balance. Is an asset. So please remember, assets will show either debit balance or zero balance. They cannot show any credit balance. Okay. Opening stock. Debit balance 50,000 rupees. Stock debit balance 50,000 rupees. Purchases. Debit balance 5 lakh rupees. Purchases debit balance 5 lakh rupees. Wages. Please tell me what balance should it show? Wages. Wages should show a debit balance. Wages. Debit balance 50,000 rupees. Wages. Debit balance 50,000 rupees. Carriage inward. Carriage inward, expenditure to transport the raw material from the godown of the supplier to our godown, to our factory. It's called as carriage inward. Expenditure, which balance should
debit
show?
Balance.
Debit balance. Debit balance, 1 lakh rupees. Carriage inward, debit balance, 1 lakh rupees. Next, sales. Sales, nominal account, incomes and gains, credit. Sales, credit balance 10 lakh rupees. Office rent. Office rent. Tell me what balance?
Debit balance.
Nominal account, expenses and losses, debit. Office rent. Debit balance 36,000 rupees. Salaries. What balance should it show?
Debit
balance 60,000 rupees. Salaries, debit balance 60,000 rupees. Next, stationery. Debit balance 5,000 rupees. Stationery, debit balance 5,000 rupees. Telephone and internet. ₹6,000. Discounts allowed. Discounts allowed. Debit balance. ₹8,000. Discounts received. Discount received. Which balance? Credit balance. Discount received. ₹3,000. Bad debts. Some debtors became bad during the year, and we have written off some bad debts during the year. Bad debts. ₹10,000. Debit balance. Repairs to machinery. What balance? Debit balance. ₹3,000. Repairs to machinery. Debit balance. ₹3,000. Interest expense. Debit balance. ₹12,000. Interest expense. Debit balance. ₹12,000. Commission income. Credit balance. ₹30,000. Commission income. Credit balance. ₹30,000. Depreciation on machinery. ₹30,000. ₹30,000. Okay, depreciation on machinery. ₹30,000. Machinery account. Deputy will show what balance first of all? It's a loss. It's an expense. Debit balance. Next. Machinery. Debit balance. ₹1,70,000. ₹1,70,000. Land. Debit balance. ₹2,00,000. Building. Debit balance. ₹1,00,000. Building. Debit balance. ₹1,00,000. Next. Debtors, that is amount receivable. Debtors, ₹2,00,000. Debit balance, ₹2,00,000. Creditors. Credit balance, ₹40,000. Credit balance, ₹40,000. Bank loan. Credit balance, ₹1,00,000. Investments. 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 4 lakh rupees. Debit balance 4 lakh rupees. Neutral balance. Capital. 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 Balancing figure. Capital. Credit side. Balancing figure. I don't know what is the capital balance. How will you find the capital balance? Total the debit side.
Debit side.
Then subtract all the items on the credit side. There will be still some difference left. Put it as capital. Capital. Question mark. Find out capital. How will you find out capital? Balancing figure. The total of the debit side should be equal to the total of the credit side. For the credit side, to get the same total as the debit side, you have to put some number on the credit side. That will be taken as capital. So what you will do, total the debit side first, remove all the items, then you will get capital balance. First, everyone go through the numbers. Check everyone. Opening stock, debit balance 15,000. Purchases 5 lakh. Wages 15,000. Please put a tick mark. Carriage inward 1 lakh. Sales 10 lakh. Credit balance. Office rent 36,000. Salary 60,000. Stationery 5,000. Telephone internet 6,000. Discount allowed 8,000. Discount received 3,000. Bad debts 10,000. Repairs to machinery 3,000. Interest expense 12,000. Debit balance. Commission income, credit balance 30,000. Depreciation on machine 30,000. Machinery account 1,70,000. Land account 2 lakh. Building account 1 lakh. Debtors 2 lakh. Creditors 40,000. Bank loan, credit balance 1 lakh. Investments 4 lakh. So, what is the total of the debit side you got?
19,40,000
is the total of the debit side. You write the same total even on the credit side of the withdrawal balance. Capital is how much? 7,67,000. So write capital, credit balance 7,67,000. See, I don't know, I was just framing the problem. I don't know the capital balance. So ultimately just put capital as balancing figure. Because that is the only number missing. Capital. Balancing figure, how much is it? 7 lakh?
67,000.
Now, total both the sides. Not over. Total the trial balance, 19,40,000. 19,40,000. Did you all get capital, 7,67,000?
Yes.
Got it? Now, below the trial balance, you write adjustments. Below the trial balance, you write adjustments. Below the trial balance, you write adjustments. Only one adjustment I'll give. Closing stock. Closing stock is of the value. Closing stock is of the value 2 lakh rupees. Okay. Now with this we have to prepare final accounts. Okay. Let us start. So we have explained the problem and now we are solving the problem. Account. Who is the owner?
Ramesh.
Trading account of Mr. Ramesh for the year ended 31st March 2015. Profit and loss account of Mr. Ramesh for the year ended 31st March 14. Particulars rupees, particulars rupees and rupees, particulars rupees, particulars rupees and rupees. Balance sheet of Mr. Ramesh as on 31st March 2014. Liabilities rupees. Assets rupees and rupees.
19,40,000.
Is everyone ready?
No sir, wait.
In this problem, we'll also write the closing entries and we'll also learn about the opening entries. What we'll do is, in this problem, we will first write the closing entries and then with the help of those closing entries, let us prepare the trading account and P&L account. Okay, go to the next page, we'll write closing entries. The accounts don't themselves walk into the final accounts. We have to make them go and sit in the final accounts by passing some closing entries. Write down, next page, closing entries. See the trial balance, come back to the trial balance. Opening stock, purchases, carriage inward, wages. These are all direct expenses which have to be closed by transferring them to the trading account. You have to close those accounts and you have to transfer them to the trading account. They don't go and automatically sit in the trading account. We have to make these accounts to get closed and the balance has to be transferred to the trading account. We'll do it by passing a journal entry. Write an entry now. Where is this entry passed? If you are following subsidiary books, you are going to pass this journal entry in a book called as the journal proper. Okay. So we are now writing entry in the journal proper. Write down. Entry number one. For transferring direct expenses to trading account. For transferring direct expenses to trading account. Now, listen to me. Opening stock account has to be closed because during the year those goods have been sold. Revenue is already recognized. Cost has to be matched to the revenue. Revenue will be credited to the trading account, sales. You have to match the cost to the revenue. That is why opening stock account also has to be now closed. It has to be transferred to the trading account. Write down the entry. You pass the entry like this. Trading account debtor. Amount you can keep blank for some time. Trading account debtor. Blank. Or I'll write the entry here. Question mark, to opening stock. What is the value of opening stock given in the trial balance? 50,000. By passing this entry, opening stock account will be credited and closed. Debit will be given to the trading account. Wait, we have to close one more account. Below opening stock, what do we have? Purchases. Two purchases, how much?
5 lakh.
5 lakh. Next, two wages. Again, a direct expense which is debited to the trading account. Two wages. How much?
15,000.
Two, carriage inward. Carriage inward. 1 lakh. Any more items to be debited to the trading account? I think these are the items that have to be debited. Now, total them 1 lakh plus 5 lakh, 6 lakh plus 1 lakh, 7 lakh. So trading account should be debited totally with 7 lakhs. Now passing these entry, all those accounts will get closed and the balance will now transfer to the trading account. Now here you write two, opening stock, 50,000. Two purchases, 5 lakh. Two wages, 50,000. Two carriage inward, 1 lakh. Now, just imagine, because of this entry, trading account is debited. Because you are saying trading account debit, hence you have debited trading account. All these ledger accounts will be credited. Right now they are showing debit balance. If you credit those accounts will automatically close. That is why they are all called as nominal accounts. Okay, stock when it is sold, it becomes nominal account only. Till the time it is sold, it is an asset. Okay. Now observe the trial balance for the next item you have. Sales. So now we have to transfer. Sales is also a nominal account. It has to be closed. It has to be transferred to the trading account. Right on. Entry number 2. Well, direct incomes are transferred to trading account. What is entry will write? Sales account. Now sales account shows a credit balance. You have to close sales account. Hence the account has to be debited. Trading account has to be credited. So what will pass? Sales account data. Trading account. Wait, don't be in a hurry. Sales account data to trading account. Where am I passing these entries? In the journal proper. What will be the posting of that entry now? Trading account, I'll write by sales. So we don't prepare the account first and write the journal entry later. We write the journal entry first, automatically account will be prepared. To pass journal entries and press enter button on your computer now, account will automatically be prepared. You need not prepare the account. We need to only pass the journal entry. Is it clear everyone?
Yes.
Now before we leave the trading account, I think there is one more item which affects the trading account. Closing stock. Go below the trial balance. Below the trial balance. Outside the trial balance. You have now come to know that out of these purchases, 2 lakh worth of goods have been
unsold.
2 lakh worth of goods are remaining unsold. Hence cost price of the goods remaining unsold should be removed. Only the cost price of goods sold can be matched to sales. So cost price of unsold goods cannot be debited to trading account, but this includes both cost price of goods sold and cost price of goods unsold. So cost price of unsold goods has to be removed. What is entry pass? Closing stock account data to trading account. Pass the entry. Entry number 3. Closing stock account data to trading account. How much?
2 lakhs.
Now because of this entry, what will happen? Because of this entry, trading account will be credited by closing stock. Closing stock is not getting closed, it is now getting opened. Because of this entry, now a new account called as the closing stock account will open. Because of that entry, closing stock account will be debited. It will show a debit balance. It has to be carried to the final accounts of to the accounts books of the next year. Hence, the account balances which have to be carried into next year books are shown in a sheet called as the balances sheet. It's right here, stock. How much? 2 lakhs.
2 lakhs.
I have left this space for fixed asset and this space for current assets.
Current asset.
Stock, 2 lakh rupees. I am going very slow. Please follow. Okay. And listen very carefully. I am not going to teach this again and again. Over. I think now the trading account is ready. In the trial balance, do we have any other item which affect the trading account?
No, sir.
No. Now what you can do is you can calculate gross profit. Calculate. I did not ask you to write anything. Just calculate gross profit and tell me how do you calculate gross profit. Manoj, are you following? Total of the credit side minus these items. How much do you get?
5 lakh.
5 lakh is the gross profit we got. Now, trading account is also a nominal account. It also needs to be closed and balance needs to be transferred to the profit and loss account. Trading account also has to be closed and the balance needs to be transferred to the P&L account. Trading account, credit side, the balance is more than the debit side. Credit side is more than the debit side by 5 lakh. So now the account has to be closed. Trading account also has to be closed, but credit side is more than debit side. It's not getting tallied. Hence, what do? The difference is called as gross profit, which needs to be transferred to the profit and loss account. Entry. Entry for transfer of gross profit. Entry for transfer of gross profit. So write the entry. Trading account net R2 profit and loss account. Trading account net R2 profit and loss account. What was the gross profit?
5 lakhs.
Trading account net R2 profit and loss account 5 lakh. Now give posting of this entry. Trading account will be debited to P&L account 5 lakhs by trading account 5 lakhs. Normally what do? In our last two class I said gross profit carried down, gross profit brought down, what I said you wrote. But actually that is not the way. This is the correct way. You debit trading account, you credit P&L account with the help of a journal entry. What is entry you wrote? For transfer of gross profit, trading account net R to
P&L
account. 5 lakhs. With this story of trading account is over. Trading account has now got closed. Whatever balance was left was transferred to P&L account. What was the total fee semi both sides?
12 lakhs.
Now the story of P&L account will start. You already have the gross profit. Now see your trial balance. See your trial balance. Office rent. Wait. Office rent should be debited to P&L account. It's a period cost. It's a cost relating to the period under, we can say, accounting. Now we are trying to calculate profit for the year ended 31st March 14. This expenditure belongs to this period. Hence it has to be matched to the gross profit of the period. It cannot be matched to the goods sold. It's difficult to find a relationship between office rent and the goods being sold. And actually office rent is not affected by your sales activity. Whether you do any activity or not, you have to pay office rent. Okay, so now office rent has to be transferred to P&L account, it has to be closed. Next item, salaries, again it's a period cost, it has to be matched to the profit of the period. P&L account, stationery, transfer to P&L account, telephone and internet, indirect expense, transfer to P&L account, discount allowed, transfer to P&L account, discount received is an income credited to P&L account. Next, bad debts is a loss to be debited to P&L account. Next, repairs to machinery has to be debited to P&L account. Next, interest expense. Interest expense is for a period box, you have taken a bank loan for the year. So for that year you have paid interest. So this interest is not for the, it cannot be matched to the products being sold. It can be matched only, it can be related only to the period under consideration. It's an expenditure relating to period. It's not an expenditure relating to number of goods sold. Okay. So it has to be debited to P&L account. Next, commission, income. Credited to P&L account. Depreciation on machinery. Again a loss for the period to be debited to P&L account. Next, machinery, land are assets. Building is asset. Debtors are assets. Creditors are liabilities. Bank loans, liability. Investment assets, capital assets. So now, capital is a liability, asset for the owner. Okay. Now pass an entry. Entry for transferring indirect expenses to the P&L account. Entry for transferring indirect expenses to the profit and loss account. Now you will pass an entry like this: profit and loss account data entry number 5, no?
Yes.
Profit and loss account data are blank to rent. How much was office rent? 36,000. To salaries. How much?
60,000.
To stationery. Now all these accounts were showing a debit balance. To close those accounts have been credited and P&L account is debited. To stationery, 5,000. Now wait, what will happen is actually when you pass this entry, the posting of this entry will be P&L account debit, rent account credit. Salaries, P&L account debit, salary account credit. Stationery, P&L account debit, stationery account credit. Once you do that, no, the account will get closed because it is already showing a debit balance. Write the exact same amount on the opposite side, the account will balance, it will get closed automatically. Okay. Next, after stationery, telephone and internet. How much? 6,000. Next, discount allowed. How much?
8,000.
Next, bad debts. How much? Don't tell me incomes, only tell me the expenses. Yes. For incomes, you will pass separate entry.
Yes.
Next, yes. After bad debts?
Repairs to machinery.
Repairs to machinery. How much?
3,000.
Next?
Interest expense.
Interest expense. 12,000. Depreciation on machines. How much? Next. That's it. Total all these items? 1 lakh. Properly total?
1,70,000.
1,70,000 rupees. Now give posting of this entry in the P&L account. To rent 36,000, to salaries 60,000, to stationery 5,000, to telephone and internet. How much? Telephone internet 6,000.
Discount allowed.
How much?
8,000.
Bad debts. 2 bad debts.
10,000.
How much?
10,000.
10,000. 2 repairs.
3,000.
3,000.
Yes, sir. 3,000.
Next, 2.
Interest expense.
12,000. To depreciation 30,000. So I've debited all the incurred expenses to the P&L account. Now see your trial balance. There are some indirect incomes which have to be now closed and transferred to the trading, not the trading account, P&L account credit side. Write down entry number 6. Entry for transfer of indirect incomes to the P&L account. So everything happens through a journal entry. No account will automatically go and sit in another account. You have to make it sit through a journal entry. Information would not move from one account to another account without you making it to move. It is static.
Not volatile, it doesn't have its own feet. If you forget to pass any entry, the account book is not going to open its mouth and say that you have kept some entries pending and keep quiet.
Suspense account.
Next. Stop. Tell me what is the entry you have to pass now? What are the internal incomes in your travel balance? You have discount received credit balance and
commission
income credit balance you have. That's it. Only two items. So those two incomes have to be now closed and transferred to P&L account. Commission income is showing a credit balance. How will you close it? Debit the account. Discount received is showing a credit balance. How will you close it? Debit the account. Credit which account then?
P&L account.
What entry you pass? Commission account data, discount, received account data. How much was commission?
30,000.
Discount received?
3,000.
2. Profit and loss account. 33,000. What is your doubt? Ask.
Sir, commission and loss, it is the money coming in, it should be debited. But later, I understand
that it is a commission received, cash account is coming in. But cash is coming in for what purpose? For an income called as commission. So you should not worry about cash. Why has cash come in? That also you have to ask. No? It's an income. Cash is coming in for an income called as commission. So we are talking about commission income. P&L account credit side you write by
commission.
How much?
30,000
by discount received 3,000 over all indirect expenses, all indirect incomes are over. Now we can calculate net profit. Calculate, I did not ask you to write anything. Calculate net profit. Total of the credit side is 5,33,000. 5,33,000. Out of 5,33,000, subtract these items and tell me what is the net profit. Tell me what is the net profit. 3,63,000 is the net profit remaining. It needs to be transferred to the owner's account, called as the capital account. So you have to transfer the net profit to the owner. Profit belongs to the owner. Hence, the profit should be transferred to the capital account of the owner. Pass an entry. Pass an entry. P&L account credit side is more than the debit side by 3,63,000. To close the P&L account has to be debited. Capital account has to be credited. Write on entry. Entry for transfer of net profit. Entry for transfer of net profit. What is the entry you pass? P&L account data to capital account. Profit and loss account data to capital account. Unless you pass this entry, P&L account will not be closed. P&L account data to capital account. How much? 3 lakh?
63,000.
Now go to capital account. I think we don't have the capital account yet with us. So whenever we write the capital account in the balance sheet, this net profit needs to be added. Okay. Now we have closed all nominal accounts. Now come back to the remaining accounts in the trial balance. What are the accounts left? Machinery account. How much? 1,70,000. And it is after depreciation because depreciation is already given within the trial balance itself. Can see machinery account, depreciation of machinery in the trial balance. That means the machinery balance is given after depreciation. So this account need not be closed, boss. It has to continue in our books till the day machinery is there. So all the balances which have to continue in our books have to be shown in the balance sheet. Okay. machinery, I have left some space because we have some land and building also, no?
Yes, sir.
I have left some space for them. Machinery, outer column, 1,70,000. No entries passed. No entries passed to close the account. It's only a sheet. Balances sheet. We are not passing any entries to close those accounts. We are just listing down the balances. We are classifying the list into asset list and liabilities list. Next, after machinery?
Land.
Top.
2 lakh.
Land, how much?
2 lakh.
2 lakhs. Again, land account cannot be closed. It has to continue in our books till the time land is there.
Building.
Building.
1 lakh.
How much?
1 lakh.
Now, please tell me, land is showing what balance in our books? Debit balance.
Debit balance.
Building is showing what balance in our books?
Debit
balance. Machinery is an asset, it will show debit balance. Stock is also showing debit balances. The same balances have to continue in the next year books on the same side. If these accounts are showing debit balance in current year books, next year also they should show debit balance only. You cannot just put them on the opposite side in the books of next year. Okay, next.
Debtors.
After stock, you will write debtors. How much?
2 lakh.
2 lakh. And this is after bad debts. This is after bad debts. How do I write after bad debts? Bad debts is appearing in the trial balance. That means bad debts ledger account was prepared. Why was bad debts ledger account prepared? Because an entry was passed. What was the entry passed? Bad debts account, debtor to debtors. That entry was passed, bad debts account was debited, debtor account was credited, and after passing that entry, after completing the posting, we are given the balances. So the balances given to us are after subtracting bad debts from debtors. Okay. So next item, creditors. We show it on the liability side. Creditors, how much? 40,000. Account cannot be closed till the time you settle the creditor. You have to pay off the amount to close the account. Creditors, 40,000. Next, after creditors?
Bank loan.
Bank loan. How much?
1 lakh.
Bank loan, 1 lakh. Investments. We assume it is a long-term investment. Asset side, investments, how much?
4 lakhs.
4 lakhs. Last item, capital. What was the capital balance in the trial balance?
7
lakhs 60. Now, to that we have to add this net profit, no? Because we passed the entry, P&L account and R2 capital. Capital account has to be credited. Capital account is already showing a credit balance. If you again credit the account, balance will increase. Capital account is already showing a credit balance. This entry is asking you to again credit capital account because you have got profits. Profits have to be given to the owner. His account is already showing a credit balance. If you again credit the account, balance will increase. So I'll go to the balance sheet and say add net profit 3 lakh. 63,000 total in the outer column. How much is it?
11,30,000.
See, if you open capital ledger account, by balance brought down, 7,67,000 is there. And then we are saying P&L account retard to capital. Capital account again credit by P&L account. Credit side 767, again credit side 363. Balance will increase. Are you able to understand? So how much it? 11,30,000. 12,70,000 is the total of the balance sheet. Now, listen to me carefully. We understood that all nominal accounts are closed by transferring them to the trading account or P&L account. Trading account is closed by transferring the balance to P&L account. P&L account is closed by transferring the balance to the capital account. Yes? Now what about those accounts? Accounts are shown in the balance sheet. They will continue in the books even in the next year. See, this is your attendance register, but still, let us suppose this is a ledger. Okay, leave it. It's a ledger. Now, suppose in this ledger we tear off all the pages for nominal accounts. Their work is over, no? We tear off and throw it in the dustbin. And after some time, you will find that there are hardly few pages left, 4 or 5 pages left. And what are those pages? Accounts relating to real accounts and personal accounts. Nominal accounts you have removed because the balance was transferred to trading account, P&L account. Accounts are useless. Nominal accounts are prepared only for the purpose of calculation of profits. Once profit calculation is over, they can be thrown into the dustbin. So in your ledger book, if you remove all nominal accounts, the size of the ledger will reduce. You will hardly have few papers left. My question is, can you continue with the same book next year? Same book?
No.
Can you follow with the same book?
Yes.
Yes. Hardly few pages left.
Yes.
Yes. No, it's not possible. Because next year again you will have a lot of transactions. This book will not be sufficient. So what we have to do is, now this book still has certain accounts which have some balances. Assets and liabilities. The ledger account still contains certain accounts called as the assets and liabilities. So next year you will take a fresh ledger, you will buy a new ledger book, fat book. What you will do is, whatever balances are there in those accounts, assets and liabilities, those balances have to be incorporated into the new ledger, and then you can throw this ledger in the dustbin. Normally you don't throw it in the dustbin, you put it safely in a locker and keep it safely. So what you do, whatever account balances were left in the old ledger, in the real accounts and personal accounts, those balances have to be transferred. Will not copy the entire ledger, only the balance which was there. Will copy the balances in the new ledger and then put this ledger safely in a locker. And this new ledger will now start using for the next year books of accounts. So now how do we bring those accounts into the books of next year? Write down. Opening entry in the books of next year. We have learned how to write closing entries. Now you have to learn how to write opening entries. Opening entry, not entries. Opening entry in the books of next year. Not in the current year books.
Next year books.
The books of next year. Now, listen to me. I want all these balances, I want all these accounts to continue in the books of the next year with the same amounts. Now, I would ask one question. Land, last year books 2 lakh. Next year books can I write 20,000?
No.
Continue. Debtors was debit balance 2 lakh. Can I continue next year books with debit balance 50,000?
No.
You cannot change balances, boss. The same balances have to continue in the books of next year. So let's start reading now. Now tell me, these accounts were showing which side balance? Debit side balance or credit side balance? Land, building, machinery, data, stock, these are all assets. Either will show debit or zero. Rarely they may show credit balance. Okay. But normally they should all show debit balance. So write down the entry. Land account data 2 lakhs. Opening entry, land account debtor 2 lakhs, building account debtor 1 lakh, machinery account debtor 1,70,000, investments account debtor 4 lakh, stock account debtor 2 lakh, debtors account debtor 2 lakh. These are all the assets. These accounts have to continue in the books of next year. Hence we have debited all the accounts in the journal entry.
Now you have to give credits also, no? Creditors account should continue with credit balance. Bank loan, last year showing credit balance, next year should also show credit balance till the time you settle the account. Capital account showing credit balance of 11,30,000 in the last year books. Next year books also should show credit balance. So these accounts are now credited to creditors 40,000, to bank loan 1,00,000. Sometimes exam problem will not give you capital balance, it will ask you to calculate. How will you do it? Total all the assets, subtract the other liabilities, capital will be balancing figure. But in our balance sheet we have capital figure also, 11,30,000. The entry will tally debit side and credit side. This is the first entry which we pass in the books of next year. Okay. How will you post this entry now in the ledgers? How will you post this journal entry in the books of next year, ledger records of next year? The posting will be very simple. Listen to me. I will open land ledger account in next year books. I will write two balance brought down, 2,00,000. I will open building account in the ledger. I will write two balance brought down, 1,00,000. I will open machinery ledger account. Debit side, I will write two balance brought down, 1,70,000. Investment account, I will write two balance brought down, 40,000. 4,00,000, sorry. I'll open opening stock. This is opening stock now?
Yes, sir.
Last year it was closing stock. Now it is opening stock. Opening stock account, debit side, I'll write two balance brought down, 2,00,000. Debtors account, debit side, I'll write two balance brought down, 2,00,000. Are you able to understand?
Yes, sir.
That will be the posting, the books of next year. Creditors account will be opened. Credit side will write buy balance brought down. Bank loan account I'll open and write buy balance brought down. Capital account I will open and write buy balance brought down. From there you can start the transactions for the next year. Is it clear? This is how nominal accounts are closed and transferred to the trading account and P&L account. And this is how the real accounts and personal accounts are transferred in the books of next year. Is it clear? So we'll stop for the day. We'll continue in tomorrow's class.